on my run and launch another stuff. It's sprint intervals. I haven't done that in years. All right, so I'm looking at my house, and you can see different categories here. This is supposed to be the brick. This is supposed to be stucco. This is supposed to be siding. It's supposed to be blinds and doors. So it is kind of working. I'm going to just try basically just test out when I get to point. This is just a does have a self-intention if I want to use it. I'm just going to test out this. I'm just going to test this out to see how it does. just a regular CNN unit. See how it compares to my all my craziness. You make it bigger. I should a screenshot. Oh no, did it say? So we remember what it looks like. All right, so I'm thinking about how to pre-train my SWIN unit, and it's super confusing. Curious to see how this goes. I need to get a plan to train it. I guess the difficulty is the segment anything model, the decoder is lightweight. And I'm not sure how to make a lightweight decoder when I have four different, I'm encoding it at four different resolutions. So the decoder at minimum is gonna need to process four different resolutions. And in order to do that effectively, I feel like it's going to need to be not too small. So that's a little bit unfortunate. Especially I'm using skip connections. And so each upsample, when we process it in the decoder, we basically are upsampling the bottleneck and then adding skip connections. So, you know. Attention is all you need, huh? I'm not sure if it's going to be all I need. Thank you. Maybe I could downsample it in this to my attention block. I get to this VIT encoder is like point. Better or worse than that. It's better than that, but. All this work, I'm just going to end up using a regular. An old fashioned convolutional net. Going down. GitHub does that. I don't want it to be that. Get out of here. will have the spatial dimension, right? Am I crazy? Just the answer is fine. Double the spatial dimension. That makes more sense. So it doubles the spatial dimension, doubles it twice. This is going to be, is this to the spatial dimension? 3, 1, 1. That halves the spatial dimension, right? Three, strong padding one. That has it. It's like the classic. Oh yeah, no, it maintains it, right? So it maintains it. But it increased the... Oh, God, get out of here. So this, am I crazy or is this Mass Decoder HQ? High quality features are bypassing the transformer. So that was weird. It's weird to me. Well, here's my, okay, 0.5, 0.1. So we're gonna, now we'll see. Pop some attention on my convolutional net and see how it does. I guess we do pass it the So we are passing it the equality token there. Okay. Man, I don't know why. This simple unit might be all I need. So here's what I'm thinking. We'll break out the decoder into, what we'll call a mass decoder. So we'll have a prompt encoder. We could use the same architecture. What does this say, man? So the image encoder has its own position embedding. Doesn't the prompt encoder also have a position embedding? So the prompt encoder also has a different position embedding. The embed masks. Okay. because that's a little different than I was thinking. So the points have some idea of positional encodings. I don't fully understand that, but it's good to know. And interestingly, the masks don't, but I guess they are dense embeddings, so maybe that's kind of there. They have a height and width, so. Okay, so we have a prompt encoder, and then we have image encoder that has its own positional embedding, positional encodings. And the mask decoder, which takes in sparse prompt embeddings, the dense prompt embeddings. All right, my baby is up, so I'm gonna get my baby. See, I think my wife should be home too. Let's just check on the situation. I say that. This new net doesn't seem quite as smart as the vision transformer net. All right, I'll be back. I'll get my baby. myself. I gotta do one thing at a time. So what I'll do first is add a token. We're going to apply to the very last layer. I just gotta do something, even if it's wrong. I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna apply it to the second to last layer. Parse prompt embeddings. Okay. Pretty dumb, huh? But it is what it is. Now it needs to be times 4. Okay. That's weird to me. Oh my God. This has to be some of the most confusing code I've ever seen in my life. What I'm going to do, I'm going to see if we can I'm going to have it rewrite it. See if that can. That's the same thing. Doesn't help. Oh, mama. That's easier. How's this going? Not so good. Yeah. this might be added attention layers. Turn that base size down. Good chance that this gets a memory overflow here. The attention helps, and how much so. We're just having one. Okay, that. Get these.